I can tell you this race is gonna be really, really hard, more hard than the Olympic Games.
Everybody has a challenge here. I think it's unique for each athlete here.
It's hard to tell who's gonna be the best of the world's best.
We're all gonna rip our hearts out to be up there in the front.
It's gonna be fast. It's gonna be just sprinting, sprinting until you just die.
Nobody's coming here just for holidays. Everybody coming for fighting. To know the real giant of Rio.
I can't really think of a better place to hold the race than Rio. It's quite a setup.
The whole atmosphere in Rio is very special.
This place has got some spirit, so I think it's a really good choice.
It's going to take a lot of pictures to take home, yeah, for sure.
It's really special for us to be here with 30 degrees and to meet so many other countries.
It's special in Rio. I have all the beach and all this mountain to make every part of the sport event.
From Italy!
I suppose that's another unique fact about this event is that it is such a, you know, an international field, international athletes of all different sports. It's, you know, it is truly a unique event Red Bull put on.
Giants of Rio, there's basically four legs, starting with an ocean swim, a mountain bike leg, a speed hang gliding, and then a sand run.
The format for the Giants of Rio is unlike anything I've ever done, and I think it's unlike anything all these athletes have ever done. You know, it's a relay, which I think a lot of us are not used to, and you know, it's gonna be one person handing off to the next.
We're a team of four individuals, and that's in every event when you have four different parts, all the four parts have to work together. We start together, we win or lose together. That's a team.
It's a particular meeting of athletes of different disciplines that in the other occasion it's not possible to meet all together.
I think it's a very cool event to have the mix of swim, bike, run and hang gliding, and especially in this very spectacular surrounding. So I expect it to be just fantastic.
Now seeing all the venues actually live, I think there's a lot more to it, and it's going to be a lot harder than we expected.
It's going to be very tough. I mean, who knows what kind of currents are in there. Just have to try to make the least amount of mistakes as possible and prepare for the pain.
It's pretty hard track. In fact, there's only the first part where it's possible to go fast. It's in downtown, it's a bit flat near the beach, but after it's very hard.
It's quite difficult here, you know, because it's lots of moisture in the air and you need, it's pretty tactical race, so the guy who will go first doesn't have the real advantage.
I think this competition here in Rio is my toughest run race. It's very different to run on the asphalt than to the sand, and I hope I can do this.
Once I went online to scout out the different teams, I was looking at the different legs, and it looked like a lot of the greatest athletes in the whole world are here.
I think that we have a strong team. We will fight together and for one for all.
more team spirit is involved in this competition as normally in hang gliding. Here, if you would take a long, long time, there is another guy on the ground waiting for you. So I think there's much, much more pressure behind you to be in a team and to do good, therefore.
Eu espero que a gente briga do começo ao fim, né? Porque não depende só de um, né? Se tiver uma equipe de todos fizer o que sabe, com certeza a gente vai brigar do começo ao fim, né? A ideia é essa, brigar.
My teammates, they know the area, they know Rio, and they know the course, and I hope we can do very good. We can represent very, very well our country.
For sure, I ride for my team, for France, and also for the other three riders.
I have my opportunity to beat Julian. I could not do it in Athens, so now is my opportunity after some months.
And I hope we can fight Sunday.
Of course, I don't want to say, oh, I want to beat Julian or something like that, but for sure, I will do my best. Yeah, so we are the only all four girls in the event, and very good to show this, that the women are here also, and we want to participate to celebrate the sport. I think it will be very fun. So we are very excited.
I'm feeling very, very strong, and I'm excited. My teammates are really excited, and we are really going to try and put together the best effort that we can to win the race overall.
We're the strongest team Australia can send, so you know we're definitely going to be up there, and we're out there to win. And you know, myself, I'm just going to get out there and hopefully I can hold up my end of the bargain.
We want to do as well as we can. We want to win, but if we can't win, then we just want to beat the Aussies.
Just had an awesome experience. Really looking forward to the event, and just hoping that we have a really good race and just make the best of this experience.
Conditions are pretty cool. I believe that at 11 o'clock, the time for scheduled for the start, the sun will heat up a little bit and it will be cool.
It's gonna be a very interesting race because it has things we've never seen before, like the jump, the run, and stuff like that. So it's gonna be very interesting.
Oh, it was a good solid 3 or 4 feet out there. It's more a shore dump, you know. It basically it's real deep until it hits the shore and then just picks up and just dumps. I think there will be a lot of time gained and lost, you know, through that swell.
For me personally, since I'm real familiar with the ocean, the rougher the ocean is, probably the more in my favor it will be, because I can handle toughest conditions there are.
Chad and Kai, those guys will be really tough, and hopefully I can be in the front bunch and hang on for as long as I can, and hopefully at the end I'll have some energy to beat them.
You know, if I can get out in front and try and get a lead, I'll try to, because you know, the further I'm out in front, the easier it is for the rest of my teammates, and you know, that's the whole plan.
was going through my head here at the start of this race was basically I had to get out quick. Here is Chad Carbon, the American swimmer. We basically swam together the whole way. The plan was to basically break away from the pack.
Definitely a tactical race. I think what I'll try to do is I'll start off real strong, kind of assess where I'm at, and then that transition out of the water, jump back in. I'll try to make a move somewhere in there and see what happens.
Always hard when you swim for a period of time and you all of a sudden have to get up and start running because your balance is all messed up.
The worst part for me at least would be the diving, so I really hope that I'm not gonna think about it, just jump and we'll see.
Yeah, it's pretty high. I believe it's like 8 meters high, but that would be no problem. We'd be pumped up by the adrenaline.
The toughest part of the course for me, I think, was definitely the second half of the swim. You know, coming around that headland, and the second half of the swim was very rough. You know, it was very bumpy. You know, there was a lot of wash off the rocks, and it made things quite difficult. Chad Carbon, you know, is definitely a world-respected swimmer, and I was lucky enough, I guess, right at the end where I brought in my legs with about 100 metres to go and ended up dropping him and giving Sid, the mountain biker, just that little bit more time to relax through the run before he picked up his bike.
The whole place and pump fat face to win the rap race. And I rate that face and erase the bad taste. No shame, cause I came to entertain. Cause it pays to be fame, cause it pays to be changed in name, be trained to be fame, and you mean to the pain to the brain of a day. Come on.
You don't have any place where you can rest a little bit, just it's only flat, and then you climb, and then the stairs, it's really hard for the cyclist.
My main challenge is going to be just being able to push myself hard enough because this is such a different event. And I think it's just going to be, you know, who can bury themselves the hardest on the climb.
The hardest part was going right out of Rio. It was the steep cobbles, really, really hot. I thought I was going to pass out.
I was riding with Jeremy here and for the first half, and then basically on the steepest climb, about 5k from the statue, I just sort of rode away and just kept the tempo going. And yeah, basically I spent the last probably 15k by myself.
The
hardest thing is that we have to run up to the Jesus. I think that it's about 300 stairs up, and it will be completely exhausting. Then we have to go down the stairs. It's a really hard descent, it's technical. It will be the first key part of the race.
The hardest challenges would be, I think, to fight against the heat, to climb up all these very steep climbs. The guy with the best balance will have the best time here, I think.
You must do it 100% and more if you're gonna be, if you want to be good in such kind of races.
I was hurting the last climb. I reckon that's the steepest paved road I've ever been on. I had to get off and walk about the last 100 metres. It was that steep.
I'm just hoping to have a good run, make it, and arrive on the spot. I've got a 3-minute lead on the US team, which is behind. I think I'm just going to tuck my arms in and go for it. We're side.
Speed gliding. So it's, like I said, the super G, like a snow ski race, but in hang gliders, where we're doing basically a slalom course around different objects as fast as we can, getting down to the ground.
I think I have some advantage to know this area. I have been training here last few years. I hope I can do my best here for this event.
I wasn't sure if we could make the glide. It's sort of right on the limits for us. I was concentrated on heading for the mountain that's in front of me now. They told me if I could get to those houses about 50 metres above them, I'd be able to make it around the corner and to the beach.
So I'm waiting here at the Red Bull Arch for the mountain biker of my team to come. Then he claps my hand. I run to my hang glider, fully equipped already. Just hook in and take off. We just race down as fast as possible to the beach and make a, we call it ground effect landing, and have to spot land there. If not, we get some penalties, have to unclip and run. If we didn't make a good landing, if we made a good landing, we can go directly through the arch to clap the runner, to start the runner.
We are coming into the crowded beach of Ipanema. It was amazing flying along all those people and coming down and buzzing them, doing about 110 k's an hour. Landing on the spot was our main objective, which was the hardest part. I think only three people did that out of the whole field, so just made it inside that circle. It saved a few minutes of running.
Feelings. a marvellous event, this one, because there's so many different type of athletes running it. I mean, there's guys from Olympic marathon runners to world-class triathletes to extreme adventure people. And obviously the marathoners' strengths are going to be on the road, but that's early in the event, so I kind of like that. While we're fresh, we're on the road, hopefully, you know, they won't gain or I won't lose too much time depending where we are. When we get on the sand, hopefully I can, you know, either bridge a gap or hold my gap. So depending on how it works out, I'm looking forward to the soft sand portion of it.
The most difficult part, I think, of this course for the run is going to be being able to change the speed and the gear, really, of what we're doing, going from the very soft sand onto a hard surface.
É sempre competir e levar o nome do Brasil, né? E a gente ter a gente está sendo a equipe número um no Brasil. Não significa que é a equipe, a melhor equipe, né? Está sendo a equipe número um, ou ser a número um, mas não pode ser a melhor. Tem muitas equipes boas também, né?
I couldn't see at all how close the Brazilian runner was coming to me. It wasn't, you know, right towards the end that I actually realised how close he'd got and, you know, just kicked into an extra gear. These Brazilians were amazing runners.
Just the most amazing, you know, right from the start, when the guy base jumped down and we were all like, whoa, this is just the best event, and hopefully we've got it for years to come. We'll be back and try and regain our title.
I loved it. We all managed to hold the flag up nice and proud, and we're all very happy with our efforts after the day's events. I loved every moment of it and can't wait for the next one.